stands a majestic Jurassic limestone rock, rising up into the blue skies and gentle winds. It is the very heart and soul of Gibraltar, this small yet symbolic territory, towering above the gateway to the shimmering Mediterranean Sea. The sunlight reflecting off the rock is like its people, warm and friendly, like the gentle breeze rolling off the sea, softly caressing the sandy shores. Follow us on an exciting journey through one of the most unique and beautiful corners of Europe, a place where modernity blends perfectly with the ancient. An extension of Britain in the Mediterranean, which beautifully combines the best of both worlds. A lovely town where every street and every corner have their own story to tell. A story that even dates back to the creation of man himself. And whose present-day independent spirit has been shaped by victorious battles, heroes, and legends. One of the pillars of Hercules, guarding the entrance to the Mediterranean. A special place which has captivated the soul of mankind throughout the ages. A city of reinvention, whose economy is enjoying unrivaled growth, yet remains as welcoming as ever. Lose yourself in its charming gardens, old streets, and beautiful marinas, and feel the encapsulating spirit of Gibraltar become part of you. Be amazed by a place like no other, truly special, whose heart hides much, much more than you can imagine. Dominating the horizon at the southernmost tip of Europe stands a majestic Jurassic limestone rock, rising up into the blue skies and gentle winds. It is the very heart and soul of Gibraltar, this small yet symbolic territory, towering above the gateway to the shimmering Mediterranean Sea. The sunlight reflecting off the rock is like its people, warm and friendly, like the gentle breeze rolling off the sea, softly caressing the sandy shores. Follow us on an exciting journey through one of the most unique and beautiful corners of Europe, a place where modernity blends perfectly with the ancient. An extension of Britain in the Mediterranean, which beautifully combines the best of both worlds. A lovely town where every street and every corner have their own story to tell. A story that even dates back to the creation of man himself. And whose present-day independent spirit has been shaped by victorious battles, heroes, and legends. One of the pillars of Hercules, guarding the entrance to the Mediterranean. A special place which has captivated the soul of mankind throughout the ages. A city of reinvention, whose economy is enjoying unrivaled growth, yet remains as welcoming as ever. Lose yourself in its charming gardens, old streets, and beautiful marinas, and feel the encapsulating spirit of Gibraltar become part of you. Be amazed by a place like no other. Truly special. Whose heart hides much, much more than you can imagine. Dominating the horizon at the southernmost tip of Europe stands a majestic Jurassic limestone rock, rising up into the blue skies and gentle winds. It is the very heart and soul of Gibraltar, this small yet symbolic territory, towering above the gateway to the shimmering Mediterranean Sea. The sunlight reflecting off the rock is like its people, warm and friendly, like the gentle breeze rolling off the sea, softly caressing the sandy shores. Follow us on an exciting journey through one of the most unique and beautiful corners of Europe, a place where modernity blends perfectly with the ancient. An extension of Britain in the Mediterranean, which beautifully combines the best of both worlds. A lovely town where every street and every corner have their own story to tell. A story that even dates back to the creation of man himself. And whose present-day independent spirit has been shaped by victorious battles, heroes, and legends. One of the Pillars of Hercules, guarding the entrance to the Mediterranean. A special place which has captivated the soul of mankind throughout the ages. A city of reinvention whose economy is enjoying unrivaled growth, yet remains as welcoming as ever. Lose yourself in its charming gardens, old streets, and beautiful marinas, and feel the encapsulating spirit of Gibraltar become part of you. Be amazed by a place like no other, truly special, whose heart hides much, much more than you can imagine. Dominating the horizon at the southernmost tip of Europe stands a majestic Jurassic limestone rock, rising up into the blue skies and gentle winds. It is the very heart and soul of Gibraltar, this small yet symbolic territory, towering above the gateway to the shimmering Mediterranean Sea. The sunlight reflecting off the rock is like its people, warm and friendly, like the gentle breeze rolling off the sea, softly caressing the sandy shores. Follow us on an exciting journey through one of the most unique and beautiful corners of Europe, a place where modernity blends perfectly with the ancient. An extension of Britain in the Mediterranean, which beautifully combines the best of both worlds. A lovely town where every street and every corner have their own story to tell. A story that even dates back to the creation of man himself. And whose present-day independent spirit has been shaped by victorious battles, heroes, and legends. One of the Pillars of Hercules, guarding the entrance to the Mediterranean. a special place which has captivated the soul of mankind throughout the ages. A city of reinvention whose economy is enjoying unrivaled growth, yet remains as welcoming as ever. Lose yourself in its charming gardens, old streets, and beautiful marinas, and feel the encapsulating spirit of Gibraltar become part of you. Be amazed by a place like no other, truly special, whose heart hides much, much more than you can imagine. Dominating the horizon at the southernmost tip of Europe stands a majestic Jurassic limestone rock, rising up into the blue skies and gentle
winds. Hey! Oh, excellent. It actually is a special surprise.
It is the very heart and soul of Gibraltar, this small yet symbolic territory, towering above the gateway to the shimmering Mediterranean Sea. The sunlight reflecting off the rock is like its people, warm and friendly, like the gentle breeze rolling off the sea, softly caressing the sandy shores.
Yes. What, you don't like the cardboard and the glamorous accommodations? Good thing there's no other pictures of this. So Mick Lassen is on the bottom, Tobias Helvag, very strong German player, and Mick is always on the Danish team, so we are very excited about this match. It should go well, and hopefully it'll end at 2 because I have a massage here at the hotel.
So we are live now?
We are live, yeah.
Carter, do you know anything about the Tobias game?
Yeah, I've played cash games with Toby a lot in Chicago. He was there for a couple months. He's a strong player. He takes a bit deep. That's not an insult to him. In money games, you want to take deep. You like getting that four cube going. Met has just gotten underway, so I guess it's fairly standard over here.
Yes. So I don't really know Tobias' game that much. I've seen him around, and I've talked to him several times, never played him somehow, but I know Mick and I know his game, and he's just so strong and natural talent of the game, basically. So
yeah, and
my impression is that Tobias is very strong as well, so I think this
Tobias is very strong. He's been out in Tokyo playing, he's been all over the world. I see him at Monte Carlo a lot. I realize now my live stream is feeding back, so.
Okay, so we have a
6-3.
Well, is that a decision?
What is he thinking? Are you not making the 5 point?
Yes, you definitely want to make the 5 point.
This may be the best blunder I've ever seen.
Well, yeah, it's probably not going to be a 200 or anything, but it's obviously a clear pay. What, I wonder what he's... Maybe we missed the... Maybe he's already
maybe
moved
he's
the three?
Yeah,
No. Okay.
He wasn't awake.
What was taking him so long?
I have no idea, but it's cool because he's going to get hit with the 6-4, obviously. Yeah. That's the big mistake.
Yeah.
So Toby's looking to come in with something and a 2 to hit back, and he did. 3-2.
Very strong roll.
Mm-hmm. Mick is outboarded. He needs to come in.
If he fans, he'll get cube, probably.
Yeah.
Okay, that should keep the cube away.
2-1. Yes, those twin towers of Mick.
It's pretty good. He's leading the race big time, and Tobias is leading in prime and development.
Mm-hmm. Big time as well.
Yeah. Oh, 6-1.
Quite an important match for both players because they both lost 2, I think, and 1-2.
Oh no! So this is the elimination round for one of them.
Okay.
Daniel. Yeah.
Very good.
That puts added pressure because this is you need to win 5 to get to the playoffs. We've qualified for consolation, which frees up our afternoon. But
yes.
What do you think of this? Six? I like the split here.
Yeah, you gotta come out behind the two towers. That's the six. And with the ace, I think you just want to split.
You want to contact you too, because you want him to. He rolls awkwardly here. The 6-1 is perfect for me.
Ah, he has a small decision. You gotta make.
No, he's making.
Yes, it's a clear play. It's a clear play. So we need structure badly.
Yeah, especially since two. I think he's just safe.
Well, for a game plan and a strategic perspective, Tobias is down in the race, but is leading in structure and timing. So he shouldn't, even though you want to blitz a single checker, he should probably go for a priming style move, a containment style move.
Yes.
So I think 16 to 10 is a good six.
That's the six.
That's the six.
Is it three up or is it going to be lifting from the back? Because I really like. I think he's just thinking maybe he gets the hit back here, but that doesn't seem right. There's too much easy play for Nick with fours and twos.
I think that's you want to come out if you had a strip midpoint, but that's not the case. This seems a bit stiff to me.
Yeah, I think I would have liked moving the back checker and keeping the threes for 6-4, maybe contain.
Great shot.
Yep, 5-4. Now, if Mick avoids the two from Tobias, he should be okay.
Yeah, and even if he gets the two, he gives up the midpoint to hit.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. I think it's a good play. I think it's a good play.
I'm not sure about that one. I think I wanted to keep a little more diversification in back. Now you can dump behind with fours and fives. You come down. There's not a lot of problem for Mick. He's coming down with the four. He's going.
Yeah. Yeah, he played safe. He should play it safe.
He doesn't want to get hit here.
He doesn't want to get hit. I think the reason I like the 22-point anchor is you eliminate all the blitz
blitzing
value of Europe. So maybe in double match point, maybe you want to stay split.
Right. It's so early in the game, it's like you're afraid of the double five, double six. I mean, they exist there, but I think right now, Toby's now just praying for boxes, and even boxes isn't, well.
No, he's, he has a lot of contact value as well.
Right.
He that's the way he can win it, with contact or with a double six.
Double six, cool.
Yes,
right,
that would consist of the contact in my book. Yeah.
Slots. Yep, you want to have your board built for when visitors come a calling.
Nice.
But
nice
perfect roll.
And now he can start to consider cubing.
Yeah.
So we should know the race to know the cube.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead. I was drinking in the shred all night last night, so I will defer to you.
Okay, so that's I think he's only up five. But I did a quick count.
Okay.
I think Mick is only up five pips. But even though he's only up, well, that makes it a very
easy
take.
Easy take.
But I think it's still a double because his structure is so pure and flexible. So I still like the double, even though it's probably the double that's borderline, not the take.
Right. No, I think the take is easy. You anchored on that 3-point. A lot of times you get to run off with a six. You get to run off with sets as well as.
And especially if I did the count correctly.
Yeah.
It's got to be a tick. Okay, so you come down, leaving 6-2.
I think so. You may just go to the ace.
Well, I think maybe there's a timing here as well, because
he rolls
Toby has to. Yeah, he has
6-1,
to.
6-1, something like that. He's
got to
perform too.
6-5. He's got to move with the sixes.
Yeah.
Ah. Okay, now the race is crucial again.
Right.
If he's up in the race, he could consider him.
Yeah, he doesn't. There, Mick only has a couple pick and passes. 5-2, 4-2.
Yeah. I think I need to count the race one more time.
Yeah.
Demanding. Okay. So let's see.
You want to count red? Right?
Okay, count red. I'll count the white.
Right. 114 for red.
Okay, and Mick is 92.
Oh yeah, so yeah, and I mean Toby does have 11.
But that's before the roll.
That's before the roll.
Oh wait, 98. Sorry, 98.
Okay. I think
so. Mick is still up a little bit after the roll. So he should probably make this play. Yeah, I think.
What's going on with the lighting there? I think they're setting the mood. So Mick is just trying to avoid any kind of hits.
I think he should play 7-1.
Yeah, I like that.
Not giving the flash up and making the 4-4.
Not only do you make the 4-4, you also keep a little outside just in case he runs with the 6. You wanna have an attacking position because Toby's gonna be breaking down pretty quickly. It's maybe a little too much. He hates to see a 6-3 here, even a 6-4, and Toby's race is close enough where you want to contain that checker.
I know Mick is not gonna make this play.
Does he make this one?
I don't think so. Because Mick, he never gets the race wrong. And I think the race will give you the answer. It's too close for making a clearing. He needs to have a bit of offense in his position as well.
It's pretty crazy. I didn't expect it. Toby's usually a quicker player than Mick. Mick's very deliberate. And I didn't expect that Toby would already have 2 more minutes on his clock.
I think he's probably making a better.
Yeah. It doesn't work. Yeah, it looks like Mick is considering the 6-4.
It can't be that bad.
Right.
No, but he has the builders. If he runs off with the 6-1, 2, or 3.
My words. Yeah. Well, I don't dislike this.
No,
play.
This is the
I like this play.
This is the miracle of the commentary when we don't have Snowy judging us or XG judging us. We are completely right, and these guys are playing this horrifically wrong. but he's thinking he needs the builders.
And he don't want to leave the 5%.
Right. And look at this double five. So now Toby's going to be forced out with any 6 as well as 40. I can't see. If it's a 6-4, then that gets a little, it's going to get a little hairy because you really want to use the 6 to cover. Yeah. So then the 6 has to cover. Oh, if it's a 5, yeah, that does suck. 6. Yeah. The slotting's not that bad, but if you get hit with that 1. See, certain players in Chicago would keep putting this back and forth until he gets perfect board and better distribution. But sadly, Mick is too much of a gentleman to make that kind of play. So
it's like in this position,
very stiff, very stiff. But
the fact that the race are close makes the decision different. Because if he was leading 20 pips, he should just save. If he was down, he should slot.
Yep.
So the fact that he's only up, but
the board weakening.
The
board,
yes.
But the
wasting the pips in the race.
50 what? 50. It's probably gonna be shot. It's like 53 or 54. Yeah, because otherwise Mick would be clearing this thing like nobody's business.
5-1, 5-2 places. So. Oh, it is 5-2.
Oh, okay.
How he could clear
oh,
the
he
seven.
Can clear the yeah,
he
clearing
clear the
sevens.
Seven, that's probably the right idea.
Right. Yeah, you want the now the fives when he's forced off now with any sixes, any four, like a lot of fours. Half he has to leave a 5, any 5-1, things like that. He's gonna. Because I think now Toby's leading the race.
But he's wasted so much.
See, in this 5-1, here it is.
Yeah, maybe he's the pip count is even, but Mick
oh,
is
yeah,
leading
the
race.
Yeah,
the wastage is just very bad. 5-1.
Five
hits.
5-1.
Okay.
Yeah. Mick adds to his wastage, but he slows Toby down. Toby's trying to get out. 5-3. Still in shooting range for Mick, so
Mikkel would love to see a 5-2 or a double 5. 6-2 it looks like, so there will be a hit. And now Mick is hoping against hope for no 3.
3-5 is funny.
3-1. Oh, that's a great number. Toby gets the lift.
Yes.
And now Mick has to come in pretty quickly. 4-3 is a fan. Toby's going to probably go. Wow, I would have thought Toby would at least look. Maybe he has the race down, but I would at least look to see.
Yeah. Well, now he should start to consider it, I think. You need to have the race. Can you count the red checkers once again?
Yes, I can.
Okay.
Okay, so. Sorry, got 56, 57, 58, 59, 60.
Okay, we have 77 for Mick.
And 60 for Diaz.
Okay. 67 for Mick. And how much for Toby?
It was
60 something?
Yeah, 60 something.
So he's up a bit now.
Yeah.
He's up a bit now, but oh, there's a lot of shot in it for
43.
Yeah. So Tobias is up in the race, so he's just safety's a check.
And Mick has to stay back. Oh, unless he rolls double four.
Whoa, bam, bam, bam.
Gotta be good.
Yes. And then I believe you go into the 3. You want to fill that hole.
Yeah.
Yep. And Toby's recount again. That is the one thing about, especially in the end game, you're always making sure you're perfectly efficient.
Mm-hmm. Now Mick is counting the race and making sure that he should go for the race and not for contact. Well, he can't
well,
even
he
go
can,
for contact.
The contact would be horrible.
Yeah.
I like, if they're listening, I would like this light filter because everything looks fairly clear. Let's see how the dice pop out.
Now Tobias is counting, I think.
Yeah, Tobias is counting.
And he realizes that.
Yeah, that's a great roll.
That is a great roll.
So Mick is. Oh, 3-6.
Might be the underdog now.
Yes. Yeah, he's definitely. He's got to be down in this race, right?
But yeah, not enough for Tobias to reach him.
Yes. But Tobias isn't going to have any holes if Mick rolls a 3 or 4 right now. He's definitely going to feel it later. But being a professional Danish player, Mick would not bother to roll a number that would start gapping for him. Now, Tobias is a professional German, though. He's trying to move as fast as he can. So, 2 what? Double 2s. That is perfect. When you can unstack with 4, Toby's cube action here is leaving it alone. So, yeah, this looks like a cakewalk for Mick. So, yep, 6-4. The only 4-1 be that. No, because Toby's odd, too. So.
He really needs. Oh, I thought it was a double 6. I thought it was a double 6.
He needs a set.
Yeah.
Yeah,
Mick's
not even going to give him interest. So Toby needs 2 sets right now. And even if he rolls 1 set, he doesn't get the equity of the redouble. Oop. So he rolls 1 set.
Yeah, and now
but
he has to
he
dodge.
Will not get the, he will not get the reship
in. Dodge. Yep. He gets the chance.
Okay. Yeah, any double here for Toby wins the game.
He's so sick.
But no, Mick is.
We need
6x and not a 6-6. So good game.
Yeah, how was this game? We had Mick leading the race, but down in development, and the opposite for Tobias.
Right, and then it turned into just a simple hitting and then racing out. Mick performed well. His double fours were huge there, getting all the way around, and he never missed. He never gapped, and he never missed. One checker difference there would have.
Let's see how Tobias plays this week. I'm curious. Okay, he's down 2-0. Okay, yeah. It's one of those moves. It's kind of gives away the personality of the player. Mm-hmm. To see how he plays.
Sometimes with that 3-1, you see, especially the beginners, they're so eager to hit. the making the 5 point is so clear here, and you give up pivoting on the on your opponents.
Yeah. Well, actually, from the book A of Paul Weaver and
Neck
Ballad.
Yes.
My favorite backgammon book. I learned that it's a complete borderline decision after the opening 6-4 and coming out and coming down and 3-1 hitting or making the 5 point. Because the builder on the 9 point is very active, right. So you gain more tempo by hitting in compared to 6-2 or 6-3 opening, where you want to make the 5 point.
Right. So we're going 6 down. Yeah, I'm still waiting for chapter 2 of that book.
Yeah, book
by the way.
Book B.
book B is still in development.
Yeah.
But Paul's been pretty busy helping his mom in Alabama, so I know he has had time. Mm-hmm. And Nack's kind of enjoying being away from the back. I mean, his wife plays a lot, but he hasn't been playing as much. So.
Okay.
All right, 6-2. Is this... You could
hit. He should hit, of course.
Yes.
And I don't understand what's taken him
well,
so
long. Well, he's thinking, well, this little prime versus that little prime, maybe he runs out. So getting hit back here is a pain, but you don't want him to anchor on your 4 point.
Yeah.
I like this play.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, it's true that the race is very important. You don't want to get set back in the race, but you got to hit. You have the best inner board, you have and your opponent is on the edge of the prime.
Right.
And you have the builders to do it.
6-3. Some kind of 4-3, 4-1, 5-2, making the 2 point. I know, but you don't want that checker.
Yes, you have to.
Yeah.
It's like, it's painful to give up purity when you are lacking ammunition. So, yes.
And Toby just got some nice ammunition. So, I don't know, I think you have 3 options. Mm-hmm. Doubles are the hardest numbers to play because you have such a variety of plays here. Come up safe, make 3 point, make 2 inner board points that are really strong, the 5 and 3.
I think he's making the 3 point regardless of what play he's choosing.
It seems like the 3 should be easy. We can hear the seagulls, I don't know if you're getting the feedback.
So he should creep up if he...
That's not the worst.
I think it's weak.
This seems better.
When you have one checker back, you want to develop your inner board because you're vulnerable to getting hit, and in hit contests, you want to strengthen your inner board. I like this play.
I like this too. All right, 4-3. Huh? Great roll for Mick.
Golden point.
Yeah.
Good old golden point. I just reread McGrill's old backgammon book, actually.
Oh, yeah?
And I realized that in the book, he only calls the 20 point.
The golden point. Yeah, I was going to say.
Not the 5 point.
The 5 point. The 5 point for so many players is the golden point. But yeah.
It kind of shifted, right?
Mm-hmm.
But originally, it was the 20 point.
43. And then are you beginning your 4 point here?
Yes. Yeah. He's a pure point. It's kind of like in the US, you call your left wing liberals.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Which is a little bit strange for us Europeans that you call Democrats, the Democratic Party, the liberals.
Right. Well, there's a
like
lot of strange stuff going on in our country right now.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah.
I'll be applying for my Danish passport pretty soon if things don't straighten out.
This was an analog to the being the 5 point called the golden point.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of like.
So Nick's building a board here.
Mick is building a board, and Tobias is counting a race because it definitely looks like Mick's.
Ah, okay, yeah.
43.
The race is, of course, the crucial factor.
Yeah.
And I guess Tobias counted it and saw that he wasn't leading enough. And with this kind of structure against 20 point anchor, you would need to be like 13, maybe even a little bit less, maybe even 12 pips up.
Yeah.
Something like that.
Oh, it was Tobias thing about breaking the back.
You can't play now because the mixed inner board is too
strong.
Oh,
no, yeah, he's not going for a shot, but
never
he's... You hate putting your builders on your ace point, your 3 right now.
Yeah.
So 5-2. Well, he's, I know he's, Mick's now running off, so he's gonna stick around.
Yeah, he can keep the midpoint one more roll.
Yeah. Toby's counting. All right, so it looks like Toby's up too. 6-1. 6-1 is not a good roll for Toby. He is breaking something for sure. He's not going to volunteer a shot against Mick's board, so he's losing his 9, 8, or 7 point. Maybe the 7 here, because then you can cover the ace.
I think the 7 point is too crucial when trying to bring home the midpoint.
All right, but this is going to be a... You double now you get the advantage.
Now
Mick can keep that ace there,
because
that ace is crucial to hit and to cover.
It's like so. a ghost point.
Exactly.
You have the same function as a point, but you don't need to have two checkers on the point.
So
Mick
like
sees it, and of course he...
That's okay. He's
what are you scared of?
Double ones, 1-4. Ooh, 1-4 would have been a kind of a painful number.
He'd
hit and then he covers the two.
He wouldn't have hit because that would have left him a shot.
Right, so but he would have hit there and then covered the 2 points.
No, he wouldn't because Mick would have gotten a direct shot from the bar.
Right, at an ace. Right.
Yes.
Yep.
But so that therefore Tobias wouldn't have hit because he don't want to leave any shots.
Right.
He needs to place.
I don't know, you gotta also pay off to... Oh, there's no cube involved yet, so...
No, no. Mick's was double three, so what's the race
double
here?
Threes. Mick is down. He's only played half the roll.
I think Mick is... up 5 pips after the roll.
Okay.
So I guess generally you want to minimize contact when you're ahead. 5 pips is very close.
Yes, it's borderline, but these other threes aren't going to great places.
Yes,
so
that's probably why this, even though he would somehow like to keep contact since he has the stronger position. This is probably just the best.
Toby's 3-2 spot, making a 4 point here. He does have some residual contact at Mick's checkers there. Yeah,
I don't think so.
Away.
I don't
what
think
do
so.
Think
I think
do?
You want to play as racing efficiently as possible.
Okay.
So I think he should play 7-4, 7-5. The contact is very, very,
very minimal.
Minimal. So I think, and the pip count is completely even. So I think he needs to play as racing efficiently as possible. And making the 4 point is kind of inefficient.
It is inefficient, but knowing Toby's game, I bet we're about to watch a 4 point. Oh!
Good play. Very good play.
All right, Mick, roll a set, just bring this home. 4-1.
I think Mick is up 5.
Dancing. Double 4. Mick's signature roll.
So unless Toby is producing.
I don't know if your
counter is right, maybe
not. Yeah, this looks like... Yeah, he just rolled double 4s and he's still rolling.
But if yeah.
There's
but
perhaps
if
we don't have the XG analysis, but when you roll 16 pips in a baron,
yeah.
we may have an awful look. So, yeah,
but even
so.
He moved the double 3.
Hold on. So. Yeah, well, look, I mean, so he's down 10, there's 13, so he's down 3.
And he just lost
9.
His market.
No, the market's not lost yet.
You don't think so?
Okay, so
let's see. 57 with white. 57.
6 pips. It's 6 pips. It's 6 pips, and he's got a strip 3.
63 for. What did I say for white?
It's 6 pips.
It's
look, here's
yeah.
So down
that's
10.
That's 50.
Plus 6, 4,
55.
3, with that checker. That's
57 for white and 63, wasn't it? 57. I keep forgetting the first.
It doesn't matter. It's going to be 6 pips. So if you're positive on one, just
yes.
add or subtract
okay,
6.
Okay. So it's 57, 63.
Right. So Mark
so
Olson.
And even you have
a direct count, and I do comparative count. So that's
no,
I
normally I do comparative counts as well. I just think in this one it's better to just do yeah. the. It's
and Mark is right that you should have the actual count is much better to have than doing what I do. But at certain scores, it saves on clock time.
Big market loser,
so.
Because he already had two
had
checkers,
two checkers
off.
Yes.
So that in my inner effective pip count, I think it's bootcamp inspired.
I wouldn't be surprised if this was a tip. I mean, yes, you have the two checker difference, but you're also score based here. You're giving up the point.
But
now
the score
he's eight
beats
away.
Very, very little.
That does.
In a race.
But man, those recubes are tasty, Mark. You gotta come to Chicago for the cash game.
He's down 6 pips and he has 2 checkers off.
That's
so that's
true.
2
yeah.
penalty pips per checker. And he even has 1 plus over more. That's half a penalty pip. So I think it's not a tip. I even think just by looking, it looked like a cube. Probably not. I would trust in Mick making good decisions.
Yes.
He knows the
no, I wouldn't say that wasn't a double. I wasn't. I'm not 100% on it. Everyone can make their bar. That's kind of a nice feature to have.
It's a great running roll, but I guess you have to do what to be a system.
6'5". Tobias has some outfield control if he doesn't get popped with it. 5-3. Okay, Mick needs to respond and respond with hitting. 3-2. Yeah. No, fives and twos are dangerous. Is that my massage? Is that my massage warning? Oh yeah, oh that's a nice thing. So Peter's probably Peter's running right now. And of course he did it all in Danish, so I have to get my translation with it. Oh, you can't tell Carter Medic you talk too much.
But
nice.
But then Peter, you know that he's a commentator, right?
Yes.
This is the only
he
knows.
No, we're good friends, so it's just funny. He's kind of busting my balls about it.
He's considering the pure play. Okay, that play I don't really like. Stripping the midpoint too early.
Yeah.
While staying back deep with back check.
Right, you want that. I think you want the advanced anchor here.
Either that or slotting the 5. This play I do not like.
Yeah, you don't want to. You're already trapped behind. Coming in on the ace just traps that checker. You're going to need a combination of numbers to get out. You don't want to see that.
Aesthetically. This
yeah, it looks
kind
ugly.
Of like it's ugly because your position breaks over in half.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to stay back deep and strip. But I
this looks good.
He was considering
slotting. I like the slot. Yeah, so many numbers make the 5 point, or...
It's kind of conflicting with the, no, I don't like that play.
Yeah,
it's more safe.
No, but that heavy stack on the 6 and the stripped everywhere else is bad.
Yeah.
And here's the double 4s, so he gets hit.
So what about the last 2 4s?
Yeah. Interesting. I instantly think hit, but is it possible
to
make it 5?
He has to hit.
Yeah, but those other checkers, that ace now is a nice agitator.
I think you want, of course you want to hit, and then I think you make the 9. And this is one of the weaknesses by stripping the midpoint. We see now that even if he enters with a hit, he has to give up his midpoint to hit
right.
those checkers.
That's true. There's the hit.
Yeah. This is a good point.
Mm-hmm.
It's priming the 22.8.
3-6. Ugh. And there's that checker. This the is problem with the checker on the ace. So you're slotting your two.
He's lacking mobility, and now he has to put an ugly checker.
Yeah. So you'll probably see Tobias cubing fairly quickly.
Mm-hmm. He could actually consider cube here, just because Mick is so weak.
Yeah.
But yeah, he decides to consolidate.
Makes the 4 point, you can cover and come down and just give a 4 shot, duplicating the 4. Yeah, I think this is probably going to be it. You don't want all these loose blots. I mean, you're going to have 3 loose blots if you do this play.
Yeah, so he can either have 1 blot, or he can do this play, which is...
And have 3 blots.
It's a cool play, this one, because it's... You take advantage of Wick's weak position to develop something even better and more attacking.
That's true, but you're going to really...
Definitely more blitz value in this position. Yep. I kind of like it.
Okay, well...
It wasn't the obvious one, but I made it simple.
Oof. It goes from bad to worse for Nick right now. So he is stripping. 6-1 cements, double 4 cements. You want a little more contact? No, he's being cubed out, I think.
I think you're right. The cube is coming. So can you take after?
Yeah, any of these plays? Maybe this is the lure. Sometimes you make these plays, the person then will think they're too good, not cube. You know, maybe you get that. No, it didn't. That didn't work.
He's too good.
Yeah. Yes. This did not work. So, Mick, do not fall in love because you're leading 3-0 and trying for a shutout.
Mm-hmm.
So.
I think he has to let this one go.
Yeah, especially that checker that's now on the ace.
Mm-hmm.
He's trapped.
Yeah.
So. Good matches so far.
It's 3-1. I think Mick made one poor move in this one.
Obviously, it's
not a blunder, but it's just it ended up costing him a lot.
Yeah, like how different does that look when he's anchored on the 4 instead?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Then he doesn't have that ace liability. He doesn't have those problems.
Yeah, and he has a spare in the midpoint. He has mobility. He's never gonna bury checkers like he ended up doing. So.
Back to the swing of things. Tobias is looking for some kind of double to just pound away. 6 is out. Is the 3 a hit?
Mm.
Or is it just continue?
Too strong. I think this is the right idea.
Yeah.
I'm not the strongest in the opening theory.
Now, if David Rockwell was here,
mm-hmm.
he's mastered the first 3. And it's amazing to know the 3. For money, for the positions, there's so many variants.
Yeah.
So it's funny, we make bets and then we just turn to him instead of looking at XG. So it's always handy to have somebody like that around for bet settling. So 4-1.
I think this is the right idea.
Yeah.
What's the name of that guy? David?
David Rockwell. He actually helped with Neil Kazaros to do the rollouts for XG.
Mm-hmm.
So. Very strong Chicago player. Shout out to David Rockwell and his lovely wife Linda, who just stopped running the Peoria tournament because of issues with the USPGF. So that's a side note that we'll bring up at another backgammon after dark. All right, 16 makes the 4 point.
Yeah.
Mick is content with this. Toby's still looking for those double 3, double 5, 5-3. Pointing on, yep. Did you get to attend Mochi's lecture on back games?
I learned something. For me, obviously, I do know how to play back games at a certain level, but what I learned was that in my mind, the most important principle was it's always been efficiency of the checkers. So I got a lot of the problems right. But for Mochi, I think there's something even more important that is like.
Ooh, dancing here is not good.
Like the battle of the pips. I underestimated how much like each pip and timing.
Here's the 5 point.
Timing means.
Mm-hmm.
So I think I learned something. I got something out of it. So that's great.
4-5. Mick has gotten himself into a bit of trouble while we were discussing Mochi's back games. So it is, but 3 loose checkers for Mick and some definitely hitting positions for Toby. Being down, he may be thinking about it. Yes. And it looks like he's going to make the 8. What? I think Toby's wrong with this assessment. That's weird. Yeah, so. Yeah. I'm wondering how much our voice carries to the next room. Like, what the hell is this? Oh, I mean. Yes. And these double ones. Oof. Double ones would have still been hitting Toby and making the 5 points. So. Oh, 2-4. And the re-hit. So you have a prime versus prime. Interesting. I don't think you can come up to the 4. You've got the 5-4-3. Yeah. That's true.
I mean, coming up with 2 and 3 points seems too stiff.
Yeah, that doesn't seem. I would either come down with the 2 or come into the 6. This looks too stiff. Well, evidently they can't hear us because Mick would have heard us bemoaning. Now it's you've got 5s.
It could be the right. But I think he.
Alright. Okay, so Mick needs some 5s, and 5-2 is duplicated.
Good running shot. Okay, he knows this one.
Yeah.
He knows this one.
Yeah, you
well
have to contain.
Mick.
You have to contain have to here.
Force. One check. Yeah. And he didn't even have to think about it.
This looks takeable. Yep.
Cube by Tobias.
Toby may be thinking he should have cubed a little earlier, and you're having buyer's remorse. But this 6-3, and now here's your problem. He's stacking on the 6.
That was an aggressive cube.
Yep. And all it takes is a 2 or a 6 from Mick, and that one checker's behind a 5 prime.
It's not too bad to cube, even if it could even be a double, I think, but. It's definitely on the aggressive
three?
Side.
Ugh, what about that 3? I kind
of
like the...
All of them are ugly, right? Because you don't want
to... No, I mean, coming into the 5 wouldn't be that bad.
But you want to have the checker with the spare checker to work on the 7 point.
Okay, so 1...
So
what, oh,
nice,
thank you.
Nice. Yeah.
Yes.
Even though you would like to use a 5 coming out, you of course need to make
right.
It. No, I think Tobias had all his 3s were...
Oh, look at this. 2-1.
Oh.
You get the bar. You get the hit. You get a little everything. You really want to step up. I feel
what
like you it? Have to hit because you don't want to get the full prime. But how much time do you get? So if you're Toby now and you make the bar, you know now Mick has 2. He has to keep rolling a 2 to get out. And how long does he get to contain this? I like making the bar.
Because he's trapping 3 checkers right now.
Right.
3 checkers, that's a lot of prime value.
That is. But he's also given up the cube. So Mick, some of his 2s are almost instant reships.
This is a tough one.
Yeah.
It's a tough one. He could do this and go
try to make the 4 point.
Make the 4 point, yeah. And maybe like it's a distraction, so you try to escape while blitzing.
Right. This seems like a lot of loose checkers, especially.
Yeah. How
you're
many
paying
shots
off.
Is 4-5-4-6.
4-5-4-6, and that's it. But 4-2. Look at 4-2. Double twos also. Yeah.
2-5.
In the States now, by the way, that roll counts. So it's funny
yeah.
Seeing that. 4-3 is out.
That's one of those.
Yep.
not a bad number by any means.
No, you don't want a fan and you don't want him to develop more,
yeah,
so.
And you get to preserve your front position about another game.
Yeah. 6-5. Yep. Oh. You could make the 4 point here. This leaves shots too, and then you're. That's a lot of shots. 5-2. 6-1, of course. I think a little slightly over. It's almost a direct shot. Yep. So, and 2-3. All right, Toby's really hoping for a one or a two here.
I think Tobias has had some difficult decisions coming up to this point, and I'm not really liking all of his decisions.
Oh, look at the
Toby.
Yes, you need to run.
you need to run.
Oh, is he thinking maybe he does the six and up? No, you gotta run.
You gotta run. Obviously, he's thinking that
he's thinking
it
the
has
four
so much,
back.
Yeah, so much prime
and
that priming four checkers.
And Mick is stripping.
And he's stripping.
Unless he rolls a two, but if Mick rolls just like a small number, Toby can crack really easily too. Okay. Yeah, this is gonna be 3-1 is one of those numbers. Ooh, that's interesting. You don't want to hit here.
You don't want to, but you don't
want to
break.
Yeah, you
don't want to
break.
Security.
Sometimes people, you see those people make the, because the ace is duplicated, make the 3 point and give him the, see the double fours. How would the double fours have played if Mick didn't have to do this shit? Yep. And here come the problems.
Okay, so the prime move worked for Tobias so far.
It did. So.
Maybe it wasn't such a bad play after all.
So he's making the two, or he's making the ace?
No, Mick. Why do
so he's counting the bad numbers. So 2-5, of course, is a hit. But like 2-6 is making, is gonna give a direct shot and crack the prime. Mick really wants to, if Toby comes in, he wants to
That's
see.
That's true. That's an important. But here you have 1-6.
Yep.
So I think.
I think this is best.
Looks better to me. Purity is still important.
It's funny, this position looked so easy, and then everything kind of just goes. Yes, okay, so, ooh, 3-5 plays, 3-6. Those four checkers on Toby's three are no longer builders. So, I know Mick doesn't want to do this, but I think this is fine.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Mick needs a Toby Krakosaurus. Nope. Or here come twos. He doesn't roll a two pretty quickly. 2-1. Beautiful number. Beautiful number.
Beautiful number, yes. Now he wants him to enter on the ace.
Oh, 3-1. That is a good response.
Yeah.
Toby has to hit. He doesn't want Mick making the other anchor, leaping out and getting time.
It's a good hit. Yeah, exactly.
Double fives. Toby wouldn't have mind seeing that one. So, 4-2. Well, it was a prime. So, there it is. All right. So often you see the 2-6 from the bar in this position.
Oh. He's in good
right.
shape.
Four primes are longer than they look.
Yeah.
Not today. So, yeah. And Toby wants to be able to slash, and it's looking pretty grim for Mick right now. 4-6. 4-1 around. And Mick needs to come in soon, and he wants to come in on the two. That ace is not going to help. So, here's the five. I don't think you're slotting because you're getting slashed. Mm-hmm. 6-3. Ooh, look at this. 6-3 is not your best. Yeah. All right, Mick wants to see a 6 pretty quickly. There's
double
a 6. Is that double 6? Yes. I believe it is. Well, one way you play it to win and the other way you play it to save gammon. So I think you gotta hold the 2 point. All right, even though the blitz is coming, 6-2, here it is. All right, he needs to pop with a 2-5, and even then, he still has a bit of work to do. 6-5, okay. Yeah, 4-3, off. Ooh, I like when you fall in love with other plays, you know? Toby's not really anything. The first initial checker off is huge, you know, it gets you even. Yep, and it's a lot more flexible. Topius is. He's considering his 6-5, that gives an immediate shot. Okay, yeah. Yeah. Alright, is that a 3-4? 5-4? Yep, okay. So now Nick is looking for the ever popular 6-4 number here, which gives a double shot. 6-2, okay. It's going to be hard for Nick to save without hitting here. So 6-1, crossover, yep, that's right. Now you hate to see your opponent roll a double, but it does give you a shot. 3-2. Okay, oh, and if Toby can't take checkers off, that's helping Mick. So Mick is... Okay, that's the 2, and then he's thinking about the 3 off. Yeah, this is probably right. He has that 6-5.
Looks like Mick is...
Yes. I think the 5's out. Yeah. I mean, you don't get the bonus with the 5-3, 6-3 that you would have. Because, you know, in, so in certain positions like that, Nick has now just got to give himself a couple more pips, which Toby is preventing. Yep. No, it's not. That's the problem because you have a spare on the 3
that's
point.
Right. Sorry.
So he's okay. So here's the 5-3. So there is a shot. So now.
That's right. Sorry.
Yeah.
So it was probably okay.
Right. Okay. Now you make one, a deuce. 6-4. Okay. So now he's. Well, yeah, he should, unless Toby rolls a 7. Oh, and a hole, so.
I think he has 6 checkers on the ace point, Toby, doesn't he?
5.
Is it just 5 or there's another one?
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay, yeah. And then this double 5s for Mick should save the gammon easily. Yeah.
So we have an equal score now. 3-3.
Yeah.
I think this was an interesting game. Tobias had some tough choices.
He did. He did. And that prime that we kind of poo-pooed, definitely.
Yeah. Yeah, that was the 6-1 decision. Whether to jump the 5 prime or... Make a plan of your own.
Okay, if Toby rolls a set here, there's some possible slimy numbers.
He does.
Okay, Mick cannot see a 3. Cannot see a 3. Oh. Ah, he's off. Okay. Well done.
All the small 3s.
Yep.
So in the first couple of games, we saw Tobias being a little maybe conservative with the cube. And this game, he was maybe a little
This is
aggressive.
More, yeah, I think this is more Toby's natural state, like how he's playing. You know, sometimes also he knows he's being filmed. He's trying to, sometimes people fall in love with the XG plays, and they're like, okay, this is how I believe the computer will play. Not necessarily it being the computer play, but just the tendencies. And then when they do that, I think they get out of their rhythm. I play at a higher PR rate, but I know what I'm doing most of the game, and that seems to be important, or at least for my game, for my success. So
now it's basically an 8-point match.
Yes.
And we talked a little yesterday about the cube and these kind of scores.
Oh yeah, the
8-away.
8-away. So yeah. You love the doubled gammons here.
Yeah, they count for.
You want to get to 4-away. That's more valuable.
It's right now you want two or 4 points every time almost. So.
But I just I think it wouldn't be fair to say that Tobias has been in any way conservative with the cue.
He has.
You think so?
I think so.
Which did he miss any cues?
I thought he had one a little bit earlier in that game with Mick, when he had that kind of position where he could make the 4 point, and they took a break. Do they not realize that I have a massage scheduled at 2 o'clock? Obviously, the insensitivity of these players is galling to me. So I guess we will take a break as well, and we will be back to you shortly.
Okay. Is it just streaming? Like it's just on air?
Yeah,
all the time.
It's on all the time. I wish we had a. If we have a computer, we could see. Can people do commentary on the feed?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
We should see. Yeah. We should see if people are slacking off.
And we need to interact with people.
Okay, we are back there. The players are just about to sit back down and take a little break. 3-3, but they both already are gone through half their time. So you're going to see some time issues pretty quickly here. So here we go. Okay. So they're discussing right now, and they're off. 4-5 opening. This is roll. 5-4 split. Standard. 6-1 making the bar. Standard. Mark Olson on his cell phone. Standard. 4-2. Anchoring and coming down, trying to get some outfield control. 4-1 for Mick. He wants to split, I think.
As soon as your opponent gets his back checkers going, you gotta get your back checkers going.
Absolutely. Now Toby's looking to make his 5-point. Slash away. 5-point it is. 3-1. Nick 3-1. So he's got a 4-prime in front of Toby, but he's pretty stripped out. And Toby's hoping for a 4-6, 4-1. 6-4. 3-1. Welcome back, Dan.
Thank you.
I wish we had a camera in here to show the palatial estate here at the Gibraltar Open, that we're in the executive suite here at we were doing selfies. Okay, so it looks like he's coming out.
Yes.
5-1. Yeah, you got to come up here.
So do people send comments on Facebook or something? Okay, so we should read it.
Like yes, we should see. We should bad. I'm talking right now. The Wi-Fi in this place has been great, though.
Yes. Love it when a hotel has good Wi-Fi. Like when you go to Monte Carlo at the Fairmont, you gotta go out on the hallway
yeah.
whenever you wanna, I guess.
And wrap your head in tin foil and.
Yeah. like you lay in your bed and you just wanna send a Facebook message and you gotta go out to the
five
hallway.
One. What happened to this 5-1?
Why did you
break your.
He shouldn't.
This is already, he's got so many bills.
Actually, we've got 8-9 viewers at the moment. They can just ask us any questions they like underneath the video. If they, then we'll ask.
If you go to the Gibraltar Backgammon page, we actually have, we can respond to your comments. So
yeah.
88 people are watching right now.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, they're probably all my relatives, so thank you for thank you for participating. This is a non-paying gig, but hopefully that'll change. We'll try to get Carsten Bredel to come in and do a little guest commentating while I got my massage, but he just finished a grueling match with Peter Bennett. All right, 5-1. No, 40 what? 45, okay. Yeah, I didn't like him breaking that point. And then blotting inside, too. Oh, this is nice. The hits. And the hit again. Yeah, you don't want to make the ace point here. When you can put
bad.
The two up.
It's not that it's bad, it's just that giving you a nine is so much better.
Right. And here comes a double? No? Really?
Oh.
You don't think
what?
That's good enough to
it's
a double?
Cube. Maybe, I mean, is he too good or something?
No, he can't be too good with the two checkers back, but.
Maybe that's what he's thinking.
Okay, well, let's. Pretty erroneous thinking on Tobias's part, because now he's going to cover the ace, and if Mick rolls a 4, Toby definitely has no cue. And
I mean, it's a pass.
Yeah. Yep. I think that's wrong. Yeah. I think you just missed it. I can't think you're too good there. Yeah, and a slotted ace. See, so yeah, here, and then here comes Mick with a four and or 3-5, coming in and hitting, and Toby duplicating the fours. If Toby rolls, would crush Mick, but he doesn't get to hit twice. Well, he doesn't.
Maybe now he's
hit
thinking.
Twice.
Maybe he did take a roll on two good okay. before, because if he's thinking here, and he didn't.
Yeah, but here you also now Mick has three loose checkers, and. You know why the four? While the fours are duplicated, if he rolls 4-5, 4-2, 4-3, mm-hmm. he's hitting twice with his 3-point board.
I think this is definitely a cube as well, but
okay.
well, no. Let me rephrase. I think before was definitely a cube, and
yes.
before was an even stronger position than now.
Yes.
I think maybe it was still a cube.
Look at this. Ooh. Yeah. Six goes to a weird place. Yeah, but you can't do the other play.
I think he just missed two. The first one was a blunder, I think, and this one was a clear cube as well.
Yeah, I think
in my opinion.
Mm-hmm. I think your opinion is valid here, for sure, because I was probably passing the first one. I probably would have taken the second one. But now look at this position. Now all of a sudden, Toby's trying to figure out what his game plan is.
Yes, so we need the race to figure that out.
4-3.
Okay. So he's. I like this play. He's
yeah.
keeping the.
Well, he knows
contact.
That Mick can't, with two checkers inside,
mm-hmm.
he can't just slash away.
Yeah.
So Toby's trying to build his house really quickly.
Mm-hmm.
6-1. Okay. I think there went the other checker. So Mick needs some numbers that. Nope, 4-2.
I think the race. I think Mick was down one pip before the roll, so I think he's up 5 pips now. So
I don't like this play.
But the other one isn't.
No,
we don't like that play either. But I guess
neither's a beauty contest winner.
Yeah, no.
Obviously,
he's down one.
Yeah.
Mick is down one. I think.
I guess I could look too.
Yeah, you can't leave a shot.
No, you can't, but you're going to be really stripped.
So he's up 7.
Mick wants to see a higher number than a 6 for Toby, so his board weakens.
Mm-hmm.
Because you do not
yes.
want to be facing this. And that's
yeah.
that's
mm-hmm.
enough.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Yeah.
It's actually not that bad. He preserves mobility and...
And preserves his board
mm-hmm.
in that 6, too.
Yeah,
he
plays a one checker holding game.
So with no cube action.
Mm. Oh, and what was this? What?
We're talking back here, Carsten Brill. Would you like to come back here? Okay, 6-2.
Okay, yeah, I think.
Okay. I don't think this is that bad. I mean, I think
he can play safe.
Yes, and then now...
And he's up. Up. He's up
like 7 or
something.
He's up. He's up a bit.
Don't bleed. 2-3.
He's up 8 before.
And what's that 3?
So he's up 3 pips now. So I think the safe play would be right.
Okay, well, there's now no safe play. You're giving 8s and aces, it looks like. Unless you're duping fours, and then you're giving fours, just fours.
Oops, if he doesn't hit.
Oh, fours and elevens, yep. Yeah.
So this is 15, 17 shots.
Yep. That's a lot of shots.
That's a lot.
Almost half the numbers.
That's a lot of shots. And this is... Can you duplicate some?
Yeah,
you can do like
duplicate
this.
Duplicate fives, but that's 5-4.
That's 15 shots. That's less, so that's got to be better,
yeah,
at least.
Better number.
At least this is better. So can he duplicate the fours? If he duplicates the fours with 16 to 9,
Right, that's six, what I was looking at.
This one is
eights, fours. This is eights and fours, and the other one is fours and elevens.
Mm-hmm. So this is...
this is slightly more.
This is 17 numbers.
Yeah. I really like taking away part of the roll with the hit, but then you expose the extra checker. So let's see what Toby thinks.
I think I like the hit. It's safer.
Yeah.
And the cube isn't given, so the cube isn't in play. So.
Right. And I think that Toby actually has a decent double here because now it's not just the mm-hmm. aces and eights. It's the problem that those mm-hmm. checkers are so far away that there's not really uh-huh. connection, and Nick has to get safe.
I like this cube as well. Yeah. He has 17 hitting numbers, which he wins maybe 15 or 16 out of those. Maybe 15. And he has an even race when he doesn't hit.
So 4-3. So Mick dodges bullet number one. Uh-huh. But sadly, the gun has a lot of ammo. So.
Yeah, Tobias is staying back.
Yes. And now Mick squeezing is praying for the miracle double ace, double three, 6-1. Oh, another checker gets to go free.
Yes.
And now Toby may have some problems if he rolls a six.
I think he's up 10, Mick. Up 10 pips.
4-3. Okay, looks like he's making his 2-point. You weaken a little bit, but you still keep a 5-point board, and you gotta have.
I think you gotta do this, but. Yeah.
You gotta have the coverage. If Mick rolls anything 6-5 or below, you get direct shots.
The contact is really good here, but you always feel bad when you crunch your table, even just the slightest bit.
And Mick with the 6-4. Okay, that's a good roll for Mick.
I guess so. Yes, I guess so. It could have been so much worse.
Toby doesn't perform here.
He needs to, but even if he gets hit, he hasn't lost the game yet.
Yep.
Because of the open
6-5, that is the hit. But
the backdoor hit.
Yep, but Mick has a really nice response in any 6-0. Well,
this
would be too good to double if he had availability, and he doesn't.
Well, Carter, you're never going to win a gammon in this position.
Nope.
So you probably.
Well, I've seen the one checker variation gammons. It's
okay. Yeah.
That was the Ed O'Loughlin Sven Rumpke.
I think he has maybe 3.9% gammon wins in this position with this sort of spare checker. Very, very little.
Yeah.
But of course, you can win a gammon.
Yeah. Oh, but efficient right now.
Nice.
So Mick is hoping for one
it's maybe
of those
like
awkward numbers.
Now it's maybe like 5% gammon.
Yeah. And Mick is in, so gammons have just gone out the window. But wins have also gone out the window.
Yes.
What are you doing?
5-1?
Yes. He's like, I'm in. He's in. He thought he was maybe still in the air.
Oh, of course.
Yep. So I've seen this one, but usually as red. it's not easy to roll the three sets of sixes you need in these positions. But when you do, your opponent accuses you of cheating. It's wonderful to watch.
Yeah.
It's 6-2. It's mathematically not impossible, but it's definitely looking pretty good. That ace isn't a bonus for Mick. So now all he needs is a set of sixes to start. 4-6, okay, that's not the worst. He needs more help. Come on in. Come on in.
The drinks are here.
Oh, drinks. Sorry, our beverages have arrived. Thank you. Drinks,
yes.
Coke and coffee, so.
Yes.
All right, it's Tobias has taken the lead after up to an early start. So, but again, it's 6 away, 8 away. You want to win in 2s and 4s.
Okay, so Tobias is leading now.
Mm-hmm. Double 4.
Nice.
Yep. And down. And Mick needs a 6. And Toby's showing off his fashionable white wristband, which allows you free coffee and drinks here at the Coletta. For the low price of £25 for the weekend. Sadly, I'm not a coffee drinker, otherwise I would have availed myself to the...
You're a Coke drinker.
I am a Coke drinker.
So that's only,
I need some energy.
It's only like 12 Cokes.
Right.
You break even.
Yes, except for the diabetes that I will inevitably suffer if I have the 12 Cokes. Okay. So, 5-2.
This is a mutual holding game.
Yes, Toby covering.
In the mutual holding game, we know that the race is of highest importance and safety is an important concept. We can't really go out and leave too much.
What's this one? Yeah.
So this is Mick applying that principle, but the race is just crucial. You don't have to think too much about priming, blitzing.
I don't know. Look at the structure for Toby. Yeah, it looks, his board looks amazing, but if you look, there's 2 checkers on every point, you know. So he's stripped. He doesn't have a lot of flexibility with this, and this allows Mick makes this play. This allows Toby to run
but
the 7 fairly easily,
which gives us to leads us to the next point.
Mm-hmm.
He shouldn't make this play if he was down in the race. But I think, as I just quickly glance, the race looks pretty close right now. So he's just maximizing his racing efficiency. I don't mind this play.
All right, we're going to have to do that quick count. What do you have for white? I'm in the 140.
I think Mick is down 6 pips.
6 pips, okay.
Yeah, so maybe I didn't like Mick's play too much.
It gets, then Toby gets to do this stuff.
So
in
after 6-3, he was down, 15.
Yeah, and the 6-1
so
is great for Mick. He gets to clean up the mess he just made on aisle 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So now all of a sudden Mick is heavily down in the race, and Toby is.
Yeah, I think he's down 20 or something.
Yeah.
So, with 20 pips, if that count is correct.
That's
it's a
double. It's a double, it's a take. It's a hard point to clear. The
it's
double over there.
Clear take since his points are stripped.
Yes.
I consider so we can talk a little bit about what you consider in these kind of holding games. First of all, the race is the number one
primary
concept, and this is 20 pips, so it's right in the double take margin.
Nope.
Oh, he passed. Maybe we miscounted the race.
Nope. Oh, you can.
Ah, wait. I did. It's not 20 because Nick was down. He was down in the race after, and then he rolled the double 6.
But
so
it was Toby who rolled the double 6.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Oh, so
maybe
he was down
like 30 or.
Okay.
Okay. It makes more sense. But I was saying that you also have to consider flexibility, his bear checker distribution, and even for the defensive player, his front position as well. In this case, Mick had made some deep points, which is not really very good, but still not too bad. He could have had a fine front position. I still feel like it could have been a take just because
I would have liked the take too, and especially because, again, that two point variation, if you can whip that 4 cube.
Yeah.
But, I mean, Toby's checkers would be fairly easy to clear. He's just, I mean, fairly easy to play. He's just trying to clear.
Yes,
he's just trying to break the contact.
Sure.
So.
But I will have trust in Mick's opinion because he probably knew the race exactly. So
oh, for sure. From
if
sure
it was
Mick
like
35
right pips, it was probably a pass. So
6-3 for Toby here.
Yep.
And Tobias is under 6 minutes on his clock, and Mick is 7 minutes late.
Yeah.
Used quite a lot of time.
Yeah. Well, the problem is I think both of them are very deliberate in their counting. They want to be sure they're completely accurate, and rather than keeping a running count, they're recounting. So, which is good, but you can get into time pressure really quickly, especially with the games they've had. It's been really important to have an accurate count, as Mark and I have been discovering when we're trying to evaluate.
A lot of the decision has been really strong. But even more so
weight race oriented. What? Right, Toby's got a nice little picket fence over there that he set up 41? 43? It's a 40 something. We are all waiting to see.
4-1.
Yeah. Ace, but the five then turns to crap. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's all you got. Okay. Toby's got the nice outside prime, 4-6 outs. Everything's fairly simple. Mike doesn't have a lot of containment issues. 3-4. How many blots can you have around your board?
But luckily, Tobias only has one.
Yeah. And then
it's probably even a good roll.
Some people dance here. Or roll awkwardly.
It's a good roll. Yeah. And he has to make it. Like if he rolls 3-6 and he hits the. Leaves his angle to hit.
Well, no, he's thinking about maybe he makes the 3-point here, and it's not the worst to have that point, but the problem is so much stuff is bearing in that 5, making 5 points stuff like this.
This is a good play since Tobias has another prime value.
Yep.
After this one,
it's halved.
It's halved,
right.
Basically.
So, for those of you figuring out what we're talking about, you don't understand what we're talking about, you're trying to make the points in front. And stopping that 2 he really want to hit, but yeah. But he also knows that this isn't the hitting contest isn't going to favor him.
Yes, exactly. That's the point. So he can't hit because Mick has the stronger inner board. So now, and he doesn't really want to play 8-6. That stacks up too much. Stacks and trips. So he's left with slotting, which exposes. I kind of like his play. And it's or going up to the 22 points.
Right. I think going up to the 22 points a little better here. But move 6-2 is fun with flags. All right. So you've got options.
Wow, this is a tough move. You can hit on the ace.
No, I hate
or some
tempo
race.
Or maybe you clean up a couple things.
But you really want to use the 6 to make the 18-point angle.
You do.
What do you do with the 2s?
Maybe the deuce comes down. You're just giving a 7. I know you want to make your bar, you want to make his bar, you want to make all the bars. I don't want to hit him on that ace. So here we are. Maybe you come down with the 2. I mean, or put it where you want it. But you're giving 6s, 4s, 1s.
But he has his blood in the 1-point board with the blood. So he can play.
This isn't that bad of a cleanup, but it's where you want it.
Yes.
And the 4 is duplicated to hit and to cover.
And even the 6s, he has to leave his anger.
However, if you can do the 1-5 and double hits, you're feeling quite confident. So Mick, Mick needs a 4.
Definitely blunder potential.
1-6. This feels like a Toby double.
Should get the background noise.
It's okay, our executive suite has other people there too. So.
Bowling and Tobias is cubing.
Yeah, makes sense.
Oh, okay.
He's got some threats.
Definitely got some threats.
But I don't know if this is a pass. Mick cleaned up those checkers, so he's got three loose checkers. Well, two loose checkers and one in the air. So he doesn't want to see a three.
Can you ever pass this down on the score and?
Well, the score is definitely a factor now.
So
Tobias is five away.
Yeah, I think this is.
And he's Mick is eight away, so that he's gonna take a little bit deeper, for sure.
I have a prediction because Mick also knows that I have this massage coming up. That. He'll be able to whip to four, win the gammon, and then win 11-6. I'm sorry, Toby. I'm sorry this has to happen, but I've got 16 minutes, so 5-2. Wait, what?
Yeah, maybe this is a good play. I think Mick is leaving.
No, Mick can't be leaving the race. Look at all those checkers. I will bet that Mick is not leaving.
He's up five. He's up five.
Okay, I will bet cash money on that. We'll take a quick picture.
We'll take a picture. I don't want to take your money, Carter.
I don't want to take yours either. Oh wait, oh, this is after the play.
Mm-hmm.
So you're saying he's up one pip.
What did I say?
Tobias, you're saying
did I say five?
Yeah.
He was up five before, so he's up three now.
So he's down three. It's Toby's play, the double twos, right?
Yes, but he was down five. What did I play?
Yeah, I think you
so
were claiming that.
So, yes, so now Tobias would be up three after.
Okay.
And now he's down ten. Wow.
Oh.
Wow. So it was a huge take.
Yes.
Or the race was still...
Is that one?
A long way to go.
I don't think the four is up, I think the four is there.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Okay, one more pin for Toby. I can see my four cube coming. 1-6.
Yes, well, Mick should. He's up in the race. I have a bit of. Okay, it's a,
hits.
It hits.
Okay.
A fan now, and we might see a recoup.
I know. I'm looking for a recoup.
Yeah.
I'm looking for a recoup. 4 is way too good for Toby.
I shouldn't take party, but.
Right. We don't want to seem biased, but. Mick is a good friend and part of the Danish team, and Toby's going to be interfering with my massage, so no mercy for Tobias right now. That 4-5 was great for Mick, though, I think. I like that anchor. If your count is right, which seems to be a little suspect to me, but, all right, let's do a recount here. Yeah, that's... White is not leading.
No, he isn't. He was hit. But I think it's rather close, though. So he has the choice. If the race is close, he want to make the 11. Works as prime instructor.
Yeah,
I think it is close here in this position, so I think this is good.
Okay. Alright. To what? Okay. Oh, I don't think this is right for Toby. You're giving your sevens and some nines now. Maintain. You're going to be flying off the... 111. Yeah. Sizable. So
it's 11, and now he moves 6-2, so it's just 3 moves. Mm-hmm. It is still pretty close. That's why.
Wait, what did you say? What did you say?
122. No, 122.
Okay.
Yeah. So now it's 3 pips.
Yep.
So he still needs the priming structure. That's the, he shouldn't just clear from the rear.
Right. Just play. He has to give up that point, leaving some of those pop offs, giving you the turn shot. 3-5.
So 11. So we could
hit and cover. We
could play without the hit.
Yeah.
I think
it's too much exposure. I think so too.
Direct shot.
6, and now there is a very viable threat against Toby.
I just lost the count, but I think it's 9 pips, I think Toby is leading now. Difficult to keep up with the commentary. I tell you this.
Yeah. The computer has also made us lazy. It's very nice to be just looking. Oh, in the corner, you get to see that. Okay,
yeah,
six,
yeah, it is. It should be like that for a new commentator. Like, we need like an AI program.
Right. Well, they've been working on boards that have the kind of goes on.
Yeah, I think there's a lot of actually different kinds of projects being worked on right now that I know of. Hopefully within the next year or two, we'll probably see some of those cool stuff.
So 94 for 94 for white right now. No, 94. Yeah, 94
for
94 white.
For white.
Huge
number.
Yeah.
It just takes away all of mixed race equity, but he enters.
There's a really nice 6-1 here.
But
5-1.
There's a lot of
6-3.
I saw the 3. The 3 was up, but it was a 6 with it, so he couldn't pick and pass. So now he not only has racing equity, but also some contact equity. 6-1, 6-2 leaves. 6-3.
New shot.
Oh, wait, we even have. 5-1, 5-2, 5-2, 5-2.
Double 4. Make signature roll.
Yeah,
I like this coming.
Yeah. Now we have a race. And Mick is holding the cube, which is quite an edge.
Come on back in. Alright, so it turned into a race.
Yes.
Daniel's back.
We forget to keep to check the comments on the video.
Yes,
just
home.
Checked. There are okay.
All right.
And Falcon won his game.
Hmm?
Won his match against Kenji and the other last two team.
Mm-hmm.
Volker Sonnemann. Okay.
Yeah.
After that heartbreaking loss to Carsten Bale yesterday, which wasn't heartbreaking for me. Carsten's a good friend, but. Volker definitely had the advantage until Carsten rolled his set, which cleaned up a lot of problems.
And
speaking
strong,
of sets,
he's a strong player.
Yeah, Volker from Germany, very strong player. One of the big proponents for the German Federation. Ooh, one chair here off.
Oh, yeah. That's
okay, so.
Mike
is in a two roll position, first one having to be the sixes. Okay, Mick has to perform here, or his curtains.
Nah.
2-3.
So
no, he's got
oh
a
yes,
number.
He's got
a number.
Sorry.
Don't take it away from him.
Yes, and
all right, boxes, or is it double sixes is what we call boxes. Oh, double threes. Oh, it would have been nice. All right. So, Tobias is at a commanding lead,
uh-huh.
A three away. 8-away. So. And it's going to finish in 7 minutes. So I will be leaving in 5. So I will be coming back to you guys later. But after what I've been doing with my body here, I feel like I need to avail myself of the hotel's special accoutrement. Feeling pretty confident here, I'm sure. Not really worried. Mick has to be careful throwing the cube because unless it's a gamelish position,
if it is a gamelish position, he has to, of course, double very aggressively. But if it's a race, he shouldn't actually.
Yeah.
Just the same as in for money, maybe even a bit more conservative.
You don't want to get Toby to Crawford.
This is a good one. As soon as Mick sees just the slightest possibility of climbing or blitzing, I can consider the kill.
That's a 5 here. We have 5-4, beautiful, hitting twice. If Toby dances with one of those checkers, you're definitely seeing a cube. Glad I stayed here.
This is a cube. And this is a cube.
This is a double.
This is a cube. So
be
now we see that, Mick knows. He has so much prime value going on, and the problem with the Tobias position is he played the blitz, and when the blitz fails, it fails. Like, you lost all your purity, you'll never have a prime, and you have to rely on race or blitz. And
got the main ace point, which is both so exciting in these positions.
So when you're down in the race, but you have a failed blitz position,
And you don't mind your opponent going to 4, you don't want to see him go to 5 or 7. Okay, I squeezed out one more game. Alright, it's 155, folks. The opening 6 is I could probably stay for probably
the opening sequence
6-4. All right, I will stay to see if somebody rolls a double and just does a crushing blow. But
5-4.
Double fives is a crushing blow. So if there is a fan here,
he has to double unless he does something good.
Of course,
this is not good. This is a cube.
This is a double.
This score.
And especially with 337 and 334.
Mick, what are you doing?
Ooh, and then
what are you doing? It's even heavy. It could even be first one.
Safety.
Any day of the week, I think.
Yeah, this was good. Oh, and here's the hit. And here's also going to be another regret that he didn't double.
Okay. So Mick, you're going to cube now.
Mick is going to cube now. The market is gone.
Yeah.
So I was able to stay for another game. There we are. Okay, I need to go.
See you later, Carmen.
I will see you guys later.
Have a good one.
At
the spa.
I hope she has very strong hands because I need to be worked over.
I feel like Mick shouldn't have lost his market in that position.
Yeah.
He could have been playing a blitz with a cube. With a live cube right now, and instead he just won a single point. Okay, so it's just you and me, Daniel?
It is, yeah. So 3-1 standard opening?
Oh yeah, I think it was 5-1, 4-2, 3-1.
Yeah. And both players around 3.5 minutes left.
Yes. Yeah. So maybe we'll see some more fast-paced backgammon coming up. Been making a great effort so far to play precise backgammon, which is of course what we like. But now we see a bit of time pressure.
Yeah.
3-2. I don't like that play actually. I would have played 13-5.
Yeah.
He comes out with the blood in front of the stacked midpoint.
think Tobias just made an error there.
Oh.
It's fine. Okay, so the score is 3 away.
1-2.
6 away.
What goes to safety or steps up? Or?
So Mick is leading the race. Therefore, I think he should step up, even though it's a bit loose. That's an overplay. That's an overplay for... No, Mick.
He definitely that's an overplay. Doesn't want to get gabbled here.
Yeah, and he doesn't want to get hit. He's breaking the save or ball play criteria set out by Paul McGrill 40 years ago. Tobias has the stronger inner board, and therefore he should have some caution. 5-2, the distraction split from Tobias. Now we see the weakness of Mick's play.
Hitting.
He has to hit.
And then what? Double hit or one down?
I think even that the double hit is probably the more safe way to go.
Yeah.
But yeah. How many shots are this?
Could there be a cube coming soon?
Of course, Mick wants to double aggressively. So that's why he's overplaying the position right now.
Yeah.
If Tobias fans, he's lost his market by so much.
Double one.
Yeah. Now he's in trouble.
So another checker back and four blots.
Mick, he screwed up with the deuce.
Yeah. Just okay. One down probably.
It leaves a shot to come down, but...
How do you do that?
It's kind of terrible to play a blitz when you don't have a blitzing position. He's being primed with two checkers on the 24 point. So the position is kind of demanding a priming move, not a blitzing move.
Oh, he fans.
The fan. Okay.
Four one.
Yeah, he's cleaning up.
2 point.
Oof. Or this one.
Oh,
I think this
point.
Is better, right?
Yes.
I think it's better. Once again, the deuce point would be a blitzing move, but he shouldn't make blitzing moves.
But it would be the safer play, but...
It would be the safer play, yeah. But if you're up in the race, or if you're blitzing, you make blitzing moves. If you don't have the ammunition, you gotta make priming moves.
Wow, he desperately needs to see prime when he gets it.
Yeah. Great shot. Great shot, Mick.
And what to do with the two mark?
If he had the stronger inner board, it would be more easy to just play this one. It's even in inner board strength, so I think it's probably okay.
Yeah.
Double
shot.
Oi. What a roll from Tobias.
That was
roll.
A joker.
Yeah, this sucks.
And he fails.
It's even too good, I think. It's even too good.
Yeah.
He can just pick up all the plots and
probably has to.
Now he can look at the point shift.
Yeah.
This is a primer blitz decision. Again, like the blitzing play would be the point shift, and the priming play would be something like this. Maybe coming out with a 5 is even better. Okay. Yeah, this is fine.
So
bring
it's
it down.
It's just a play on from now, basically.
We could see a cube coming. I mean, now he has an angle. I think now it's not too good anymore. Now Mick got the anger. And Tobias is still... he has a long way to go with his back checker. That was the reason why he didn't make the blitzing play before. That's because he had so much work to do with his back checkers.
Mm.
So when you still have work to do, you need purity. If he was escaped with his back checkers, he could do the blitzing play without any doubt. So that's the... Wait, what is this? Why is he... sorry, we're forgetting the score.
Yeah.
So this would even be a take.
Yeah.
Because it's 3 away, 6 away.
And that's the reason why I thought it's a play on, even though there's...
So when you say play on, you mean no double, or...
No, just you're playing on for the gammon.
So you mean no double, or you mean too good to double pass?
Too good.
You mean too good to double pass?
Yeah.
So it makes you pass this if he was cubed?
Maybe not the score. Maybe it's a take.
If it's a take, then you say it's a It could, there are rare instances, but it's always in recubes where you have positions which is actually too good and tick. But this is very rare. But I think I get what you mean.
Those in the score, Tobias only needs like 2 pot and wouldn't risk getting the 4 cube.
Yeah, so the doubling window is actually quite narrow.
Yeah.
There's a very fine line between no double take and double pass. Yeah, Mick is afraid of blitzing with the 3 because of the strong inner board.
Double fours.
Not exactly a good roll. He needs some 6s to preserve his mobility. On the next roll, it's a good roll.
3-2.
Okay, so Tobias is maximizing his outfield control. And that's the cost is that he has to bury a checker a bit.
4-5.
Okay, pretty good. He preserves his structure. One more roll. Yeah, he needs to run, of course. Mick needs a 6, doesn't get it. Not the worst, not the worst. Okay. There it is. Okay.
1-6. Oh,
that's a good roll. If Tobias fans now, Mick actually has a shot.
Wow.
Okay.
Great shot.
Great shot. No mercy from Tobias.
6-4, fans. Double fives.
So it went from probably a no double to good double after the joker. 6-5. I'm wondering whether Tobias has missed some cubes in this game. I think he probably has.
Yeah.
But it is, as you mentioned, it's like a very narrow doubling window. When you have gammon in the position,
it's quite difficult
you're up in the match, it's like such a fine balance between no double take and two good. Safe. Basically, he wins a gammon unless he gets hit. So I think he should just play the safe play.
Six, 3.
Yeah. And even he could play an aggressive bear off since.
Double fives.
Oh, nice one.
Yeah, you can.
That's nice.
He rebuild his board. Or.
Wastes a bit of pip, he wastes like 2 pips, but he builds it, makes a 4. I was just about to say that Tobias can play an aggressive pair off since Mick has crunched his position. It just improved a little bit with a 4-point board, but there's a big difference going from a 6-5, 5-4, 4-3.
Yeah.
It's actually quite a bit stronger now, but still. Like we see here, this is probably the right idea. He needs to play for the gammon, and with a very little risk. Such a huge favorite, regardless of what play he plays. Probably this one. I can do like this.
Is it too aggressive to stick to the game plan of just taking checkers off?
No, I think I'm inclined to do it, but you have to like look at the crossovers and the probability of Mick saving the gammon after the safe play. I think he really regrets not making the aggressive bear off now.
Mick actually has a 5-point. He has a 5-point board now.
Yeah.
It's not as bad as it was just.
And moved. He gets a shot.
Okay. There's a rule here. I think. Okay. He made the right choice. I mean, getting one extra checker off is ranges between 6 to 9% in winning the game after getting hit for each checker more that you have than you have off. So, leaving 2 shots more, which is a little more than 5%, it might be offset by the extra wins just by getting a faster race. So and even combining that with the gammon winning, the gammon race, I think he just made a small error to Tobias. I think he should. Left 13 shots instead of 11 and wrote off the checker more.
No double.
Yeah, and
just
he saved the gammon.
Yeah, he did.
Really good gammon save by Mick.
So it's a little easier now for Mick to play.
Yeah, I think Tobias made some good Barov move, but I would have taken off a checker with the 4-1.
Yeah.
And not just played completely safe, as he did. And maybe even the double one. I think maybe Tobias thought about it better than we did, more thoroughly, but that was a tricky decision. Yes, we're 6 away, 2 away. So if there's any hint of gammon, we should be cubing.
Yeah. And how about Toby? How should he handle the cube in this score?
He should, as long as there are gammon in the position, what I call gammonish positions, he should basically never cube. When we get into a holding game or race, he could consider cubing. And his doubling point is actually quite close to the doubling point of money play. Of course, you have to consider that he's going to be redoubled instantly, so that has to go into your calculations. So in a gammonish position, he should never cube. He should try to win an undoubled gammon. And in a race position, he could cube. A little more conservatively than if the score was 0-0.
Yeah. So now Mickey saved his two.
Yeah, I wonder who's the favorite in this position. Oish, what a roll. What a roll.
Hitting, making the 5-point.
Oish, what a roll. That's amazing. Now he's probably gonna double unless he rolls a good number. Oish.
Wow, he fans. So there's a double?
Definitely a double.
Yeah.
The question is it a take? Probably not.
We know that Toby cannot use the cube after.
Yes, so it's a dead cube. But it's because of the gammons. He has to be so careful not losing a gammon. A double gammon.
Hey. It takes a while.
This is a big mistake, I think, at this score. But then the gammon, I think this is a big mistake. Mick has 12 checkers in the zone, and Tobias is on the bar without an anchor. Of course, he wins plenty of games because the contact is quite big, but you lose so much gammon. Mick is going to gammon him now.
Yeah.
Now the blitz is rolling. He has 14 checkers in direct range.
Only
unless
four double fours gives a return shot.
Oh, he's in a world of trouble now, Tobias. Oof.
4-2. Just making the 4-point.
Just making the 4-point, yes. Looks strong. We prefer to point on his head, but
so
he'll take it.
Now there are no return shots.
Oh, Tobias. What did you just do to yourself?
5-4.
Yep, he's getting hammered.
He can play it safe, but it looks awkward.
I mean, of course he's gonna blitz.
Yeah.
He's a big favorite to win the gammon now.
Yeah.
He
should go for the gammon.
He'll realize it. He even has the stronger inner board.
Safe play looks very bad.
It's very, very clear that you should be blitzing here. You would probably prefer to just get hit rather than him anchoring up, because you want to try to win the gammon at this score.
and yeah, I kind of like the four. Just safety stuff a bit. Not playing too many bloods.
He faints again.
Tobias, you're losing the gammon. Ooh.
Oh, he can't cover.
So do you just, yeah, you just peel it off. I guess so. Yeah. He has the chance now, Tobias. Tobias.
Oh, he hits.
But the gammon is still rolling. Mick is gonna hit loose with the. Oh, quite odd. At least he doesn't stay out. Tobias still needs to produce. He still needs to enter so badly. He does.
He does.
He does. Whoosh. He got lucky there, Tobias. He got lucky there. So he tempo hits on the ace. Nah. He probably just plays 22 to 17. Now Tobias is playing a containment game, so making blitzing moves in containment game is really quite awful.
So he has to step up with the two, right?
Of course, of course. For Mick, he's playing a like an escaping game. He's trying to get the hell out of the prime zone.
Can't hit.
Good roll for Tobias, escaping a fun position of Mick. Mick just wants to get the hell out of there.
Can't run. What's this?
Makes the 5-point board.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fine. He's probably thinking about he would like to kill his fives, and he can't with this move, but he prefers to have a 5-point board. Uh-huh. It's dangerous to hit, but he probably has to do it. I think this is a good play.
And now Tobias has got the cube, so he only needs a single win now.
That's true. He doesn't care about winning a gammon, but he cares a lot about not losing a gammon. He's basically playing just as much to save a gammon than he is to win the game. There's 50% match equity either way.
Yeah.
So that's why we're going to see extreme caution from now on. He's a 2-6 shot. But it's of course the right one to do. 1-6, very good. Very good. Very good for Mick. There are some missers.
Not that one.
2-6. Now Tobias is looking like he's gonna win this game.
Yeah, it doesn't look too good for Mick.
He had him. He had him in this game. He was supposed to win the gammon, but couldn't close out his board. Tobias got lucky.
And he's probably just going to crunch the board now, Mick.
Yes, he's going to crunch and
threes.
Trap behind a 6 prime. I think he still has maybe 5% wins. No, now less. 4% wins. Oh, wait, he has a checker off. That means a little bit. So, okay, so let's give him 7 or 8% wins. So let's give him 5 or 6%. Okay. Toby. Yeah. Yeah, why not just speed things up? I think he probably just, I'm not even sure if he prefers to hit or not. It seems hopeless either way. Of course, Tobias, he knows how to play this one. So easy. Yeah, it looks like Mick is going out, Daniel.
Yeah.
And Tobias is...
moving on to the next stage.
So, even if Tobias wins this one, he still has to win one more, right? Or he has to win two more.
they'd won twice.
I think
twice.
One more. Yeah.
No, you have to get to 5 points.
Yeah.
So he has to win two more after this one to qualify for the cup.
3 and 2 after this, yeah.
Yeah. He has to win two more after this one. Yeah. Okay, so even Tobias still has a long way to go. There it is, close board. I think that Mick played a very good game.
Yeah.
This one. There's a couple of moves we didn't like in the commentary box, like one missed cue, and a 4-1, but it was like very small amount of moves we didn't like. Whereas for Tobias, I think there was quite a bit more moves that we didn't really like, but I think that Tobias had a more difficult match as well.
Mm.
I think he had more difficult decisions than Mick had. So he's a bit excused for that one. But I'll look forward to see the analysis. I think that this Tobias just took a huge pass in this one.
Yeah.
With the score.
Yeah.
11 checkers in the zone, that's just such a strong blitz.
Could be fun to check afterwards if it...
Yeah. It's one of those blitz positions where Mick is winning the game maybe 70% of the time, and he's winning gammons. So at this score, it's just such a big pass. So if I had to guess the PRs, I think that Mick would probably have played around a 3. Maybe even a bit better. And I think that Tobias maybe played a 4.5 or 5.
Yeah.
Because I think he made a couple of cube blunders. Maybe even a... it's difficult. Maybe he played better. Between a 4 and a 5, I think.
He's not completely dead yet, but...
there is a slight chance. Well...
It starts with double 5.
Okay.
And then a 1.
Oof. Whoa! If he rolls an ace... Mick is still in it. We can't see it. There it is, the handshake. Okay.
Was close.
We got a bit of excitement.
Yeah.
We just completely ruled him out.
Yeah.
Making a funeral speech and everything.
So congratulations to Tobias, and unfortunately for us, Mick lost. Thank you all for watching, and see you in the next round, which should be in about 20, 30 minutes or something.
Good luck to Tobias. He definitely played a decent match. He had lots of difficult decisions. So good luck to him.
Yeah. And thanks to Carter for joining us. I think he'll maybe join us later in a couple of matches. And thanks to Mark for joining us as well.
My pleasure.
Nice to get your opinion on the game. So hopefully also see you later if you like. To do a little commentary.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks for now, and see you later.
Thinking about it, yeah, suddenly there are only a couple of seconds left.
Yeah, that's why I just cubed fast here at the end. I mean, I thought my cubes were pretty straightforward. So
yeah.
No reason to think about it. I would have thought.
I think in the game before you put it double trillion.
At the 3-9?
Yeah, one time I passed you 2 times, you remember?
Yeah, 4-9 and 2-4-9 and 5-9, yeah. No, 4-8 and 5-8.
Uh-huh. I don't know. Anyway, thank you. It's been a long week. It was an exciting day.
That was really good. Thank you.